New research finally reveals how inflammation begins in COVID-19. Inflammation is notorious when it comes to infection, so doctors do whatever they can to control it. In COVID-19, a new study presented what could be behind the inflammatory event called cytokine storms in patients. There are many examples of inflammation, such as rheumatoid arthritis and dermatitis. Another example is a cytokine storm where the immune system drowns the blood with cytokines. But don't antagonize cytokines, for these chemicals are critical for immune responses. According to the National Cancer Institute, a cytokine storm can occur as a result of infection, autoimmune conditions, or other diseases. Untreated, the system-wide inflammation can raise the odds of dying. A study published in the journal Nature showed what might be behind COVID-related cytokine storms. The culprit was none other than SARS-CoV-2 itself, the virus of COVID-19. Researchers revealed that SARS-CoV-2 likely belonged to select viruses capable of infecting immune cells. If HIV could infect and disable T cells, the coronavirus could infect both monocytes and macrophages. Before we go to the fiery death, let's introduce monocytes and macrophages. These are frontline white blood cells that appear at the first sign of infection. They fight germs by devouring and disintegrating them in their bellies using phagocytosis. This works on a wide range of germs, regardless of type. Here's where the fiery death in COVID-19 takes place. Based on the study findings, when SARS-CoV-2 is eaten and placed into the cellular garbage disposal called an endosome, the virus survives and begins a sinister plan. Endosome normally shuts down germs, but that doesn't work on the coronavirus. It can escape the endosome and hijack the white blood cell's machinery to make new copies, then burst free and spread to repeat the whole process. The immune system can detect this, but will respond by summoning inflammasomes, which signal pyroptosis. Pyroptosis is a newly recognized phenomenon and happens in many other diseases, though it has major differences from apoptosis or programmed cell death. Pyroptosis is described as a fiery death version of apoptosis to kill off infected cells. However, pyroptosis causes affected cells to release inflammatory proteins to alert more immune cells. Multiple cells affected by pyroptosis will raise inflammatory signals off the charts, like a small flame that grew into an uncontrollable wildfire. Linking this to COVID-19 may explain why older adults have a higher risk of cytokine storms, because their bodies have some level of inflammation already. Older people who are overweight or with diabetes tend to have chronic inflammation. Hopefully, the new targets can quickly lead to better treatments. Do you believe in the study findings? Do you think scientists can develop new therapies for this phenomenon? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.